Michelle, welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time here, then welcome, and please think about subscribing to my channel if you'd like to see more information about massage. So today we are going to cover the five top most embarrassing things that you would have to ask your massage therapist. And you know, over the years I've gotten so many questions that are kind of funny to me because I do this for a living, but I'm constantly reminding myself that other people aren't immersed in the massage world every day of their life like I am. And so they have these questions, and it's things that people actually worry about that might prevent them from getting a massage. So I've compiled a list of the five most popular questions that I get when I tell people what I do for a living, things that they might worry about if they were to get a massage, and definitely things that have kept them from getting a massage, which I feel like is so sad. So I kind of want to straighten it all out and reassure everybody that even though these things might embarrass you or make you feel uncomfortable, you need to remember that when you're getting a massage with a professional massage therapist, you are in a safe place. You're in a safe area, and that we don't care about a lot of the things that you think we would be offended by. So if you'd like to see my top five most embarrassing questions that clients ask me, then please stay tuned. Okay, so to get started with the five things on my list, I think the top two are probably pretty close runner-ups, if I had to take a guess. This is the number one and two thing that I get asked when people find out what I do for a living, which makes me think it's probably the two things that people worry about the most when they are gonna get a massage for the first time. Look, the human body is very complex, and it is bound to make noises, and it is totally natural. So the first two things that people worry about, I think, in my experience, is, am I going to fart on the table when I'm getting a massage? And God help me if that happens, what do I do? And the close runner up is, what happens if I get an erection on the table? And what am I going to do? So I did make a video all about how to handle when a client gets an erection on the table, and I will link that below. It's a funny theme because it's something that I just don't take that seriously, and I got a lot of interesting comments on that video. So let's take these each one at a time. Let's start with the erection. So in the video that I made it perfectly clear that when a client gets an erection on your table, 9 times out of 10, it's an accident. They are probably mortified. Sometimes I can tell that they just want to melt into the table and disappear from mortification. So, as a trained therapist, and we did learn this in school, we are trained to completely ignore the erection. We do the massage just like we would if it wasn't there at all. Now, I want to make it clear, we are not ignoring the human body. We are not ignoring the massage that we are doing. We are just ignoring the erection. Usually, after a couple of minutes, it goes away. Our prime goal is to make the client feel comfortable. And if that means ignoring something that they may be embarrassed about, then that's what that means. And unless they act inappropriately along with the erection, we just keep on going with what we're doing. Totally not a big deal. If the client acts inappropriately, that's a whole different story, and that's a whole different video. Farting. So I am not bothered by it. I usually have aromatherapy, essential oils in the room somewhere, or, you know, somewhere close by where I can grab them. And honestly, I've got 2 kids under the age of 7. There is not too much bodily functions these days that scare me or offend me. You know what I mean? Like I said, the human body is what it is, and accidents happen. It is so not a big deal. And every therapist that I know personally and that I've been to, feels the same way. So if that is an embarrassment factor that is keeping you from getting a massage, think about it this way. It doesn't bother us, it doesn't offend us, it shouldn't bother you. Get over your embarrassment because you are doing yourself a huge disservice if you're not getting a massage because of this. Okay, so the next thing on the list is falling asleep and snoring. And this has happened way more than bodily noises or accidental erections. When somebody falls asleep on the table, I don't get offended. As a matter of fact, I feel like it's a compliment because when someone can fall asleep in the presence of a massage therapist, that shows that they trust them. It is a huge sign of trust when you can fall asleep in the room with somebody. I do not think that they're missing out on the massage. I don't stop doing what I'm doing. I keep doing what I'm doing. And when it's time to turn the client over, I gently say, hey, are you still with me? You know, it's time to turn over and we're gonna continue. And they usually kind of, oh, wow, I was in a trance-like state. It's okay with me, really, not a big deal. Snoring is not a big deal. I am married. I have a huge dog. Everyone in this house snores. My daughter snores. My son snores. Probably I snore. So not a big deal. It goes along with the whole trust issue. If you're snoring, that means you have fallen asleep because you trust the situation that you're in with the therapist that you're in. So moving on. Body odor. Underarm odor, smelly feet. That is something that I think clients probably worry about more than they need to. Sometimes clients come from the gym, maybe they've skipped a shower that day. Maybe it's just the dead of summer and they are exceptional sweaters. Again, not a big deal. We've got aromatherapy essential oils for that. We do a thorough cleanup in our office after a client leaves the room. It's not a big deal. We've got scented foot creams if we find an odor about the foot and we can rub that in during the foot session of the massage. And let me word it this way. If things like body odor or smelly feet or textured skin, psoriasis or boils, pimples, if things like that bothered a massage therapist, then clearly they are in the wrong profession. So I think when a student is in massage school, the first time that they come across something like that is probably going to be in the clinic at school, which is part of the educational program. You learn about it, you desensitize to it as far as you, I guess, come to terms with it, you get used to it, whatever, it becomes not a big deal. Now, I've been doing this for 22, 23 years, and so those days for me are long gone, and I don't really ever remember being offended by that kind of stuff anyway. So again, if you feel like you're being judged by your therapist because of some of the things I've mentioned, then you're with the wrong therapist, and you need to find a different therapist. Now the last thing that I have on my list is probably one that's not so much an embarrassment factor as it is a fear of hurting your therapist's feelings or offending them, and that is to not speak up when you don't like something that we're doing, whether it's the pressure that we're using or a certain stroke or a move that we're doing that you just don't think feels good. I've had people come right out and say, hey, look, you're not going deep enough. Can you give a little bit more pressure? And that doesn't seem to be an issue for people. But I do find that people tend to get a little shy about saying, ooh, ouch, you're going too deep and that hurts. I'm uncomfortable with that. Or to put it bluntly, I just don't like what you're doing. It doesn't feel good. That has happened so rarely that I make a point of asking people after I get to know them a little bit and they've been to me a few times, hey, is there something that I did that you really liked that you want me to do more of? And is there something that you'd like me to completely take out of the routine? You won't offend me. You won't hurt my feelings. As a matter of fact, I rely on your feedback so that I can customize your massage to make it the best massage for you in particular. And that seems to work pretty well. Now, after each session, I do take notes on my clients to kind of chart their health progress, I write down songs that they like or music that they might prefer because they've mentioned that they like it. I write down moves that they do or they don't like. I take notes on everything so that each time they come to me, I can customize their massage just a little bit more to make it absolutely perfect for them. For me personally, as a therapist, that's a high priority. My clients are paying very good money to get exactly what they want and nothing that they don't. So I think that pretty much covers the top five most popular. I'm sure there are some out there that I'm missing, so if you can think of any that I didn't mention, please list them below, whether you're a client or a therapist. I would love to hear your thoughts. And until next time, you guys, that is it. Thank you for clicking on this channel. Please give me a thumbs up if you like the content, and please consider subscribing to my channel. And I'll be out next week with another pretty fun video about how to give a massage to your dog. So stay tuned for that. In the meantime, have a great time, you guys. Love you. Bye.